Sri Vivek K. Thanka to initiate the discussion.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Through the Chairman, I would like to put certain points which need the consideration of the ruling party who has moved this bill, which has been passed by the Lok Sabha. What is the statement of object of reasons for this act, for this bill? In short, it says the existing civil and criminal provisions are in law are inadequate to deal with the severity of the problems. And the second reason is the fugitive economic offender, who we can call FEO, Bill 2018, to ensure that the fugitive economic offender returns to India to face action in accordance with law. Now, before I travel into the law, which I will be submitting in due course, I must tell you that the money which is stacked abroad, according to well-known economists, is only 10% of what stays in India. So the moot question is, what have we done to the 90% that stays in India? Now, the best case for the government is that we brought forward the policy of demonetization. Till date, we've not been able to get the figures of demonetization. How much black money have you unearthed after that? What I am told, and that is what is in public domain, that you have received more than what you had even anticipated. So if that is the answer, then what is this bill going to do? Number two, we say that 100 crores or more should be the value of the proceeds of crime to enable us to take action under this act. Now, why 100 crores? Even an offender of 10 crores is bad enough. Even that is public money. Why pitch it at 100 crores? So one question that people are asking is, are we not willing to be strict enough for people who are within 100 crores? Now, I want to know for sure, while I'll go into the provision a little later, when people like Lalit Modi, Mehful Choksi, Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi, now together they account for nearly 2,40,000 crores. Now, if that is the correct figure, what I'm stating, even if it is 10% less or 30% less or 40% less, it's a huge money. Now, all these people escaped India despite there being parallel laws to stop them. I'll come to the parallel laws a little later. Now, the question is that the problem that I foresee in all these cases is, are we a country where we enjoy making lot of laws with no action? I remember Mr. Naini Palkiwala once addressing one of the law conferences and saying, we are a country of too many laws. Now, you have so many parallel laws which deal with the same situation. How many times are you going to attach and confiscate the same property? I'll come to that a little later. You also talk of special courts. Now, special courts has become a panacea as if it is going to solve all problems of this country. Now, if in PC Act, there will be special courts. For this bill, there will be special courts. For women, there will be special courts. For youth, there will be special courts. For SCST, there will be special courts. Now, are you even increasing the number of judges? I mean, today the state of affairs is high courts are short by 40% judges. Lower courts are short by more than 50% judges. Out of the existing pool, you keep making special courts. What's going to happen to the rest of the cases? While we broadly support the bill because we don't want to be seen as opposing such a measure, but I'm going to tell you why, despite your hype, despite the marketing techniques which BJP employs all the time by bringing such legislations, you possibly will not get the results that this country deserves. Now, please come to the bill one by one. Now, the bill, as brought here, extends to the whole of India, naturally, because the Constitution says India means the states and the union territories of India. Now, in this bill, obviously, you have no jurisdiction for people who are outside the country, who may be also co-conspirators in a crime in India but sitting abroad. You can't touch them. Now, for that you have said that we have a UN convention which says that we should, that every country who's a signatory to that convention is allowed, it must follow and cooperate with the criminal law of each other country. Now, what I'm asking you, is this bill to be treated as a subject of criminal law or civil jurisprudence? According to this bill, the only feature of this bill is that if an Indian or an individual who's based in India leaves India, either to evade arrest or to evade proceedings, to bring him back, all these proceedings will take place, which range from survey to attachment to confiscation. Now, would confiscation be a criminal proceeding or a civil proceeding? Now, if it is a civil proceeding, then foreign courts will not take it as a criminal case. They will take it as a civil case. And according to the burden of proof, in I think section 19 or some section of this bill, preponderance of probability is the measure of proof, with the onus being on the prosecution. Now, if preponderance of probability is the measure, then obviously it's a civil, it's in the nature of a civil dispute. The point I'm making is this bill strong enough to even achieve what you're trying to achieve? Now, if you come to section 3, just for a second, the provisions of this act apply to any individual who is or becomes a fugitive economic offender on or after the date of coming into force of this act. That is only when the act comes into force that you can make a fugitive economic offender. Now, if all the big fishes have escaped, who already were accused under different laws, whether it is Neera Modi, Mehful Choksi, or even Lalit Modi, or Vijay Mallya, then what happens to those people now? Will they be covered under Section 3? I suppose they can be, because who is or becomes. But that will be a matter of debate again. If it is a criminal proceeding, it cannot be retrospective. If it's a civil proceeding, it can be retrospective. But in a civil proceeding, the other countries will not help you. They will only help you if it's a criminal proceeding. So there is a legal angle to the whole thing also, nationally and internationally. Now, similarly, when you come to Section 4, it says the director or any of the officer not below the rank of deputy secretary, authorized by the director for this purpose, has reason to believe. Now, this is like the Income Tax Act, where you have reason to believe that somebody is doing a wrong. But the problem here is, you have authorized these officers to enter somebody's house without a court warrant, without witnesses. Now, if they go and plant something, will it be fair? A very big issue is that under the CRPC, whenever you enter somebody's house, there's always a warrant. And with a warrant, you also have two witnesses, independent witnesses. Now, if this minimum jurisprudence of natural justice is not followed, I'm sure in foreign jurisdictions, when you make a request against such persons, you will obviously not meet any success, because this will be cited against you. Now, there is also provision for attachment of property of third party. Now, for third party, in the bill you say that we can go to the third party's house. If the third party says that, listen, you can't come to me without a warrant, then we will detain him for 24 hours and then take him to the magistrate or a gazetted officer concerned. Now, the point is, when you reach any third party's house, would he know the provisions of the act? Would he not even know his right? And you are not, the law doesn't say that you will inform him about his right. In many laws, there are provisions that you tell the people accused that there is a right in the person whose house you are entering. Now, here, if there is no provision for informing him about his right, third party, 12 o'clock at night or 10 o'clock at night, 100 people entering his house, what would he do? And next, if he wants to exercise that right, the next thing you will do is, he is detained for 24 hours and then travel time apart, he will be taken to the gazetted officer or to a magistrate. Now, all these are very draconian provisions for citizens, I'm talking of, from the point of view of citizens. And what are you achieving? I mean, the man has already fled. He's not coming back. All the properties that you wanted to attach, you could have attached under various laws, which I'll just spell out. And what at the end of the day, the only thing that you get is a picture of a police state where police is entering anybody's house, everybody's house without a warrant. Now all these are, I'm sure, internationally also such provisions will not be appreciated. Now, this expansion of list of a search to third parties itself is very draconian. Now, even in CRPC, if you do this, there are provisions for search and seizure in CRPC. Section 94, Section 100, where you have to go with independent witnesses, where you have to have a magistrate's approval, all that has been given a complete go-by in this case. Now, the best part is, when a fugitive appears, when the fugitive appears before the authority, the law says that proceedings will terminate because he's come back. Now, why? First of all, his assets are already attached under parallel laws. What is the incentive for him to come back? I'll wait and see after the bill is passed. How many fugitives are going to come back? That will be the test, Mr. Finance Minister. Because why will anybody come back? You have already attached his properties under various laws. I'll spell out all those laws also. So if he doesn't come back, then what happens to this law? What I am trying to say is it is just because we want to bring another law to show to the world that yes, India is a country full of laws. We can take all kinds of action because the government gets a lot of publicity for such laws. But obviously, any law that you make must be there for public weal, to serve some public purpose. That's not happening. And I would further like to say that confiscation, when you do, it goes into the government kitty. Obviously, whatever property you confiscate goes into a public kitty. And once it goes into a public kitty, then what happens? Till he comes back, then of course you have to release it. There are identical provisions in many other law. So what I'm wanting to know from the Honorable Finance Minister is, you have brought in a law. I'm sure you will give a lot of publicity to the action that you're going to take through this law. But this law is being made too little and too late. After you've allowed everybody to flee the country, you're making a law. I mean, all the big fishes are out of this country. And anyway, this is for the future, you can say. Okay, I accept it's for the future. But the problem is, even these big people, you expect that they're going to come back after this law? Are you convinced that they're going to come back after this law? I know for certain, in Madhya Pradesh, when BJP came into power in 2004, it registered an FIR against 42 companies. 42 companies which are the who's who of India. And said, because you had taken loans or ICDs from the government and you've not returned it, you all are guilty under PC Act, under this Act, under that Act, for 420 and all kinds of sections. 3 days back, I was in Indore reading a newspaper that government has decided to take back all those cases. And said that we are closing the cases against 19 industrialists, and there were newspaper barons also, people of national level. So what is happening in this country, I'm asking. So the question that I'm making is that
31 minutes hain aur aap aadha aapko party ko 31 minutes mile hain aur usme se aadha samay ye lena chahe to le le wo aapke upar nirbhar hai sarkar samay ka sarokar hai na ji sarkar kya karegi isme
आप पहले माननीय बात सुन लें ये चर्चा हो चुकी है बिजनेस एडवाइजरी कमेटी में भी हो चुकी है कि कोई भी महत्व का विषय या बिल सदन के पास हो जो टाइम अलॉट करती है बीएसई चाहे 2 घंटे या 3 घंटे उसके ऊपर भी जाए तो किसी को आपत्ति नहीं ये चेयरमैन साहब ने भी आज सुबह कहा है मंत्री महोदय बैठे हैं समय ये एक विषय है कि जो लोग देश का पैसा लूट के चले गए हजारों करोड़ में उनके बारे में ये बिल है उस पे भी अगर घंटी बजेगी तो उन्होंने तो घंटी बजा दी जनता के पैसे की और आप यहाँ से घंटी बजाएंगे बार बार
ये आपकी राजनीति
चलेगा
आनंद जी
बढ़ाएं समय सीमा
ये आनंद जी
सरकार से मेरा आग्रह है इस पे अगर आप इस पे भी समय कम करना चाहते हैं चर्चा पे तो वो चर्चा निराकार होगी
आनंद जी
सार्थक इसको करना चाहते हैं इसको पूरी चर्चा करें
आधा घंटा बढ़ेगा, एक घंटा बढ़ाइए, बढ़ाइए आप इसको। टेक द सेंस ऑफ द हाउस, टेक द सेंस ऑफ द हाउस एंड इंक्रीज द टाइम।
जी आप बोलिए।
मैं ये बोलना चाह,
ये घड़ी बड़ी बंद आपने कराई है, मैंने नहीं कराई है, ये आपके कारण है और आपके समय में जाएगा वो। चलिए बोलिए।
मान्यवर, मेरा 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 ये कहना है, मान्यवर मेरा ये कहना है कि ये पूरा जो बिल है, ये जो बिल है, ये शेड्यूल ऑफेंसेस के बारे में है। आप अगर इसमें शेड्यूल ऑफेंसेस देखेंगे, इसमें करीब करीब आईपीसी से लेकर जितने भी फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस के प्रोविजंस एक्ट्स हैं, सब कवर्ड हैं। मैं गिनना नहीं चाहता, उसमें टाइम लगेगा। अब ये सब प्रोविजंस, आप यही जो सब एक्शंस हैं वो सब उस, ये और यही शेड्यूल ऑफेंसेस और प्रॉपर्टीज जो सब्जेक्ट मैटर होती है, उन एक्ट्स में भी हैं। फॉर इंस्टेंस, प्रिवेंशन ऑफ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग एक्ट प्रोवाइड्स फॉर अटैचमेंट ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मनी लॉन्डरर्स, लिस्ट आउट शेड्यूल ऑफेंसेज हैविंग मॉनेटरी वैल्यू ऑफ 30 लाख और मोर। मैंने मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग एक्ट में भी 30 लाख के ऊपर का जो ऑफेंसेज होते हैं, शेड्यूल ऑफेंसेज में होता है, उसमें आप अटैचमेंट करते हो, उसमें आप फर्दर कार्रवाई करते हो। इसी तरह सिक्योरिटाइजेशन और रिकंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स एंड इंटरेस्ट एक्ट 2002 में सेक्शन 13 प्रोवाइड दैट इफ द बोरोअर फेल्स टू डिस्चार्ज हिज लायबिलिटी देन द बैंक विदाउट इंटरवेंशन ऑफ कोर्ट कैन रिकवर द सिक्योरिटाइजेशन, आप यू टेक ओवर द एसेट्स। अगर वो बोरोअर नहीं कुछ कर रहा है, आप जाके उसके एसेट्स टेक ओवर कर लेते हो। जो कॉन्फिस्केशन है वो एक प्रकार से टेक ओवर है। देन रिकवरी ऑफ डेट्स ड्यू टू बैंक्स एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन एक्ट 1993, सेक्शन 19 प्रोवाइड फॉर द मैकेनिज्म टू अटैच प्रॉपर्टीज, सेक्शन 25 एम्पावर्स द रिकवरी ऑफिसर टू रिकवर द डेट बाय अटैचिंग एंड सेलिंग द एसेट्स अरेस्टिंग द डेटर, ये इसमें भी है। एक और प्रोविजन, एक और एक्ट है, स्मगलर्स एंड फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मैन्युपुलेटर्स एक्ट 1976, सेक्शन 4 प्रोहिबिट्स होल्डिंग इलीगली एक्वायर्ड प्रॉपर्टी एंड द सेम कैन बी फॉरफिटेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, सेक्शन 7 प्रोवाइड्स फॉर फॉरफीचर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी विच इलीगली एक्वायर्ड। आज ही पेपर में आया है, दाऊद इब्राहिम की प्रॉपर्टीज इस प्रोविजन के तहत अटैच हुई है एंड दे आर बीइंग ऑक्शन्ड इन बॉम्बे। इसी तरह आप देखेंगे फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मैनेजमेंट एक्ट, इसी तरह आप देखेंगे प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन एक्ट जो कुछ दिन पहले हमने पास किया, फिर कल लोकसभा ने पास किया। तो मेरा ये कहना है कि आप वही प्रॉपर्टी को कितने बार अटैच करोगे, कितने बार कॉन्फिस्केट करोगे या फॉरफिट करोगे, और अगर पूरा उद्देश्य इस बिल का है कि हम इसको फॉरफिट करके उनको वापस बुलाएंगे, और जब वो वापस बुलाएंगे तो ऑल दिस कॉन्फिस्केशन कम्स टू एन एंड, तो जो उसकी प्रॉपर्टी फॉरफिट हो चुकी तो वो वापस आएगा क्यों? आपने पहली बात उसको जाने क्यों दिया? आपको पता था कि दे आर विलफुल डिफॉल्टर्स, दे आर विलफुल ऑफेंडर्स, आपने उस वक्त तो कोई कार्रवाई नहीं की, और ये कार्रवाई कोर्ट में पब्लिक डोमेन में थी। कितनी बार मुझे याद है विजय माल्या के केस में कितनी बार कोर्ट्स उसके पासपोर्ट इंपाउंडिंग की बातें कर रही थी, उसको रोकने की बात कर रही थी, बट उस वक्त गवर्नमेंट सो रही थी, आपने उसको जाने दिया। इसी तरह मेहुल चौकसी की बात है, नीरव मोदी की बात है, आफ्टर ऑल उनको जब ये इतने बड़े बड़े अमाउंट्स हुए, वो डिफॉल्टर्स हुए, विलफुल डिफॉल्टर्स हुए, ये कोई एक दिन में नहीं होता है। ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर वुड नो दैट दिस इज अ प्रोसेस जिसमें जब किसी को विलफुल डिफॉल्टर बनाया जाता है। तो अब ये सब आप यू प्रॉब्लम हमारी देश की ये नहीं है कि हमारे पास लॉ नहीं है, प्रॉब्लम हमारे देश की है कि वी डोंट हैव द विल टू स्टॉप सच पीपल। अगर हमारे देश में विल होती टू स्टॉप सच पीपल तो ये चीज़ें नहीं होती, इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लॉ। लॉ तो आपके पास बहुत है, इतने सारे लॉज हैं, जब आप उनको कॉन्फिस्केट कर सकते हो, उनको अरेस्ट कर सकते हो, उनको बिहाइंड बार्स भेज सकते थे, बट हमने नहीं किया कभी। हम उनको पहले जाने देते हैं और फिर हम एक बिल ले आते हैं, उस बिल का उनके बिल के माध्यम से हम बताना चाहते हैं, देखिए हम कितने विजिलेंट नेशन हैं, हम कितने अलर्ट नेशन हैं, हमने देखिए ऐसे इन लोगों के लिए ऐसा बिल ले आए हैं जिससे कि अगर भग के भी जाएंगे तो लौट आएंगे। कैसे लौट के आएंगे जब उनका सब प्रॉपर्टी ऑलरेडी कॉन्फिस्केट हो चुकी है? अब वो प्रॉपर्टी छूट नहीं सकती, अब वो जब तक उसके उनके लौटने से ये प्रॉपर्टीज कोई छूटने नहीं वाली है। तो प्रॉब्लम दूसरी है इसमें कि आपका जो ये बिल है, हम सपोर्ट करेंगे, बिकॉज इसलिए करेंगे क्योंकि आप हमको नहीं तो कहोगे कि हम ऐसे लोगों को प्रोटेक्ट करना चाहते, बट हम आपको बताना ये चाहते हैं आपके माध्यम से सदन को कि हम उनको प्रोटेक्ट नहीं करना चाहते, हम सरकार को बताना चाहते हैं कि जो आपने लाए हैं दिस इज टू लिटिल एंड टू लेट, और आप जिस प्रकार से लाए हैं दिस इज अनदर लॉ दैट यू एडिंग जिसमें ऑलरेडी रिपीटेड ऐसे एक्शन हो चुके हैं और इससे कोई अब फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला है। और मैं लास्ट में फिर से कहता हूँ ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर को, आई विल कम एंड कंग्रेचुलेट हिम अगर ये चार लोग जो मैंने नाम लिए हैं बार बार, इनमें से कोई इस लॉ आने के बाद अगर वापस आता है तो मैं उनको आके कुछ चाय पिलवाऊंगा इन द सेंट्रल हॉल। थैंक यू, जय हिंद।